God bless you. I'm Apostle Smith.
And I'm Prophetess Shabarn Smith.
And we just want to say God bless you to each of you, our Facebook brothers and sisters in Christ. We want to welcome you to this end time Facebook update on what we believe is going on in the end times. And I just want to say God bless you. Thank you all so much for sharing the videos and for just praying for us. Amen. We just came out of a three-day, amen, prayer revival and how the Lord moved.
Yes.
Listen, today's word is, amen, what role does angels play in the life of the believer? As we approach these end times, we need to know, amen, that God has unseen, invisible, angelic forces that are working for you. Yes, you. The Lord has these angels that have been assigned to protect you in the name of Jesus. And so we know that there are two kinds of angels. Amen. We know that there are angelic angels and then there are demons. And we know that Satan, with the one-third of the angelic force, was kicked out of heaven because of insurrection. And so they work against, amen, the angelic force. Mm-hmm. But we know that God's angelic strike force is prevailing. And as we enter the end time, praise God, and we enter into another realm of spiritual warfare, you need to know that God has given us the ability to dispatch our angels, not to worship them, but to dispatch them and to release them to do warfare every day. I fail not to release angels to protect. Amen. And most times, angels are not seen because they work in the invisible world. Praise God. They work and they only manifest themselves in a physical sense when they get permission from God. We're doing a special teaching on the angelic force.
Yes.
But we want you to know, amen, that this week will be a week, amen, that angels, I believe, will be watching over you. And many of you have gotten delivered from car accidents, etc. But we know it's because angelic forces have been working on your behalf.
Amen, honey. And I release my angels every single day. I do not leave without releasing the angels to cover me and cover me, my vehicle. And I release the angels over myself, over my family, over my immediate family, over my sisters and brothers, all relatives, my mother, praise God, over our spiritual, our pastors, our spiritual parents, over all of our spiritual sons and daughters, amen. Even the churches that we cover, I release the angels every day to cover them, praise God. Even those that we fellowship with, the churches that we fellowship with, and people that are even associated with us, that we have covenant with, I release angels to guard them and protect their vehicles every single day, praise God. So if you have not been doing it, release your angels, amen. They're here. Like Apostle said, we're not here to worship. We don't worship them, but I do release them daily. Praise God. I utilize them because they're for us to use. Amen. And Apostle will say all the time, don't let your angels be sitting somewhere on vacation. Praise God, on the beach somewhere drinking a virgin daiquiri. We should be releasing them every single day to guard and protect. Praise God. So just be encouraged today. If you have not been doing it, start releasing your angels and start covering yourself. Amen. Amen. And cover your vehicles, covering your children everywhere that you go so they will cover you and bind and block the end of the enemy.
Amen. Amen. And as we have entered the last days and we know that warfare has been sent out against the people of God on every hand, and as it intensifies, as we go into the last hour, praise God, you want to stay under the blood of Jesus and you want to make sure, amen, that your angelic forces, even though you may not be able to see them, praise God, but know that they're working in the invisible world to bring about safety for you. According to the 91st chapter of Psalms, that he will dispatch, that he will release his angels, they will take charge over you and to bear you up. And the Bible also talks about that some have entertained angels unaware. We'll talk a little more about that on next week, but we want to encourage you, amen, to know that God is working on your behalf. We also want to invite you to our prayer, amen, line on Tuesday, 8 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, our prophetic prayer line. Please join us with your prayer requests. Call someone or just encourage someone that may not go to church that they can also call this prayer line. And remember to go with God and he will go with you. Shalom.